Welcome back to the 100K Pod, Season 4, Episode 6, The Return of Tom Cruise. He's back from surgery.
Jack Reacher is here.
It's the old most like job for me.
Jeez, he looks good. No, but seriously, welcome back to the 100, the AFL edition of the 100K Pod, where each week we look to turn $10 into around $100,000 from one individual multi. We get all of our best legs from the week. We come together and put on one massive AFL monster multi to try and hit the Holy Grail eventually. Jev, welcome back. How are you, my friend?
I am good. Thank you very much. Got a little joke for the boys. An absolute 12 out of 10 smoke show. Oh. Hottest chick we've ever seen walked into a gynecologist. The gynecologist was sort of taken aback at how beautiful she was, said, "Okay, sit on the seat. Do you mind if I numb the area first?" "Of course," she says. "And num 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 num." That's good.
I'm trying to send messages out to try and get some sponsorship for dishing up that sort of stuff.
Lewis, how are you, sir?
Go with funny. I'm good. I'm up and I'm a little bit down. I'm up, obviously, because I'm back.
Nom, 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 nom.
I'm up because it's... Do you need a minute? No, it's good. It's good. I'm up. It's the weekend. It's officially the Twos football Coachella season. The Groove and the Moose starts this week, Darth. How good's the setup? The Twos football league. He's knocked on the door down just to get in the ones all year since October. Kicks three, round three, and then gets a tap on the shoulder from the ones coach, and he's going to Grooving. So I'm all about that. So shout out to the boys heading up to Gruden.
Yeah.
I'm down though. I'm back on the pod. All I wanted to do was bet on the translucent crayfish. Probably the All-Australian ruckman. Yeah, I can't bet on him tonight. Yeah. So I hope he features in the multi. I'm talking about Big Tim English. So I hope he features tonight, Jeff. But yeah, thanks for having
me back. Get him in, Jevy Fridays. He's a stud, yeah.
Now, boys, a bit of a mixed bag last week, Jeff. We went 14 out of 25 legs with the multi with the shark last week. Give us any bad legs that you had, my friend.
So started us off like shit. LDU 25, only had 23. So we reloaded on the multi. Bailey Dale 20, he only had 17. Tim Kelly 25. He had 22. Was that Tim Kelly? Yeah, Finn Callahan 20. He had 18. So not that great of a week from me. Bad legs from Co.
Yeah, I think I just the one, but he had Melbourne head to head, so he wasn't that happy about that. But probably not a bad leg. I thought he just got dealt by the Bombers.
Yeah, they did.
And he had stiff. Redmond.
Yeah, he had
Redmond. Yeah.
Only had Ash Johnson for me, Jeff. Unfortunately, just thinking. Right, yeah, had a pretty good week. Had I might as well go through. We had Petrarca for 25, Bond Libber for 20, Dangerfield hit his 20, and Sicily only just with the 20. Jeff only just got there, but still got there.
Yeah, I had Sinclair for 25, Jeremy Cameron 3-15 club. He had that in the second quarter alone, and Clary for 30. Thought we were in trouble at about three quarter time when he was on about 15, and then he had what 20 in the last. I was saying 25 in the last quarter. Ridiculous. He ended up on 40, so that was a green tick, Lou.
Yeah, he had Ian Hill just for a snag. That was cash.
Bobby.
He was really happy with this. Just Jesse Hogan for two. He kicked two goals, four. So only just got there, but six scoring shots. So that guarantees yourself a good leg.
Yeah, good.
No, it was good. The other legs were fucking stiff, Jeff. Now, the 10K Punters Club, it is lock and loaded. It is back. Morgs, can you give us a quick run through on what that is to all the new listeners? What is the 10K Punters Club? How does it work?
I can. It was nervous times. Just put the bet on. Putting $1,000 on the bet. It was scary times. 100% on. So we'll film the promo after this and we'll get it on the Insta. But essentially, you join the bet with mates on Sportsbet. It's a $10 buy-in, a maximum of 100 entrants. You boys have put, mostly you boys have put the bet on this week. In future weeks, we might go to People's Choice, which we've done in the past, which we've had three or four attempts that have only missed by a leg, so we threw it to the people. Don't need to do that yet, though. I think you guys are in some good form. Yeah. I've watched Hook, Line and Sinker. Watch Sunday Rose. I think I like your form. So the bet is on. I think it's only 8 legs, is it, Darth?
Yep.
So we won't reveal it on the show. It'll go up on the Instagram, but the return, you get $100 back if we win, and basically 100 blokes trying to win 10 grand.
It's unbelievable. We've been so close last year. We almost got to the stage where there was so many bad beats. We cut it off. But start of the year, we've watched footy for a few weeks. We've got our irons. We reckon this is the week. On Wednesday, Jeff, we had Hook, Line and Sinker. A heap of feedback. Thank you for everyone. Obviously, we try to message as many people. Really appreciate you guys getting back to us. We want to try and make this as best as we can. So we appreciate that. And Jeff, coming up next, here comes the money.
Yeah. The show we all love to watch. Here comes the money straight on YouTube. Me and Darth put $1,000 in a sports bet with my sports bet account, start of the season, and we're documenting every bet we put on. I'm up. Darth is so-so. Huge bets put on. We absolutely love Here Comes the Money.
Yeah, I'll be starting my own pod after saying there goes the money.
What is your account at the moment?
You'll find out. You have to listen smart, and find out. Smart. Now, Morgs, before we get into the games, we had a lot of messages about when do we find it. I won't even say anything because I'm not sure how much you want me to say, but We got some a very exciting prospect.
Yeah, well, we just want to let the people know that it's a tough process getting this 100K out because the copy bet isn't working. We've got to the bottom of it. The multi just pays too much for you to be able to copy it. I don't know what the threshold is.
What's the situation? So what do we do?
The situation is, so we've made it easier for everyone. It won't be live until next week. We're starting a Patreon, Das.
Patreon?
For $2 a week. It's an absolute bargain. You'll get every same game multi within the 100K multi in a link. As you go, you can just add them to your bet slip and it will combine to create your own 100K multi. So we can send same game multi slips. We can't send the 100K. Yep. So it'll be on the Patreon. If you don't know what Patreon is, it's basically just like a private Facebook page. It will cost you $2 a week. But with that, Das, you get, which I think is honestly the main event, is entrance into the Discord.
Yes.
Now, we've started the Discord this week, so you might have seen it went up on the story, but it's basically just an absolute footy hub. We get so many blokes talking to us, chatting about who we like tonight, but no one else gets to talk to anyone else.
Yes.
So, and there's nothing else out there that I know of. So it has taken a bit of work, and this Patreon will take a little bit of work, which is why we're only charging a measly $2. But that's honestly a fucking bargain, if you ask
me. And a few of the headings, obviously, we're going to have like announcements, giveaways on that, but we got some footy talks, winning bets you guys can say if you guys have won any bets, future bets, Super Coach, any bad beats, NBA, NFL chat. We can even check a baseball if you guys are into that. And obviously got all links to our YouTube and all our different podcasts and Instagram and stuff. So as we said, it's just going to be a massive hub. If we have like a Sunday Arvo same gamer, we can plug it in there. Everyone just gets around it. Everyone can have a good chat. So big banter room as well. So it'll be fucking awesome. So very excited.
It's surprising. Obviously there's a lot of people out there that will never have used Discord. It's basically just like a private Facebook Messenger, but it's actually even more surprising how many people have asked for it. So we can't wait. It'll probably be live next week, but you'll find out about that on the Instagram.
All right, boys, we're excited. All right, so here we go. Let's crack into it. So the first game, Port versus the West Coast Colts. The West Coast Colts, boys, we all know how depleted the Eagles are at the moment. Apparently, Will Schofield's playing this week. Wirrpanda, Glenn Jakovic, Michael Gardner, and Michael Gardner's drug dealer will actually be playing this week for the West Coast Eagles. Well, that's done. How depleted they are. Chief, do you have a leak for us?
Port versus Wet Toast. No legs for me. Because I cost us first game of last week. So I'm going to stay away from the first game of the week. My juice is coming later. Lewis.
I'm refraining from any jokes. So I just left this one alone.
Yeah, look, I'd actually probably rather bet on the rugby union than this game. So Super Rugby League, boys, the Rebels are actually getting the points plus 16.5 at home against the Crusaders at $1.90. Could be one to look into later.
You like that better than Port?
Yeah, potentially. Yeah. All right, boys, next game, GWS and
the
Brisbane.
Rebels aren't in the bet. Don't put the Rebels in the 100K. They're not in it. It's just a bit of a game.
There could be something to look at. GWS and Brisbane, though, boys.
No legs for me, and it hurts me, but I've got some great legs for Here Comes the Money. You have to come in after. No legs that I absolutely love in the 100K because of the lasagna, because of the juice I'm giving you later. So nothing for me. Lewis.
Lasagna. Yeah, I couldn't crack into the... I came here today with a leg, but just couldn't crack it into the multi. It will feature later on in the 10K Punters Club. I like Chuck Cameron just for two. So it was $1.59 for two. I don't think we got him for two slightly in the 10K Punters Club, but you'll find out about that later. Jeff, you dropped him 2 weeks ago from the pyramid. Since then, he's been hotter than a camping marshmallow.
Yep.
It's unbelievable. He's kicked 4 goals and 6 goals. I absolutely love him for two in the personals, but couldn't get it in, so that's okay.
It's an absolute lock, actually. Cameron for two.
Is it too
against
late?
Against GWS. Fuck, yeah. That's a good leg.
No, just use the leg. As I said, this is what Das, we want to keep saying. This is what the pod's about. Don't necessarily put the 100K on. Use it. You might disagree with some legs. Take what you like, but take this one.
Yeah. Hey, speaking about some individual bets, Morgs, this isn't in the 100K. I couldn't find one that I do like, but the USA presidential election, I'll tell you what, boys, you can currently get 340 for the Trump to win back the throne. I'll tell you what, I reckon this is a fucking lock, boys. So maybe look into that Donald Trump 340. Next game.
Once again, that isn't in the 100K.
It's not, Trump, but it could be one to take. All right, boys, here we go. Geelong and Sydney. Do we have something to kick off the 100K, Jeff?
The safest bet in football for the best player in the comp. Jeremy Cameron, 2-15 club. Das, his season so far from round one, 2-16, 6-25, 3-15, 7-22, and 4-18. It's hit every week with fucking ease. First game at GMHBA, unveiling of the flag. He'll just get there. He'll just kick two and he'll have 15. Now, for my Nuffy Swan supporters, I know I'm the biggest Nuffy Swan supporter. I have legs for the Swans. Don't you worry. They're just coming in. Here comes the money. This is the best leg for the 100K, and that's it for the 100K. Swans leg, here comes the money. I've got some juice.
And only just to appeal to me then, does that mean Papley kicked 6 and 25, didn't he? Yes, he did. So there's two blokes in the 6 and 25 club. That's unbelievable.
It's a good club to be in.
What a club to be in. Darce, Zach Tui, $1.25 I got for 15 disposals. This bloke is more consistently good than a Woolworths mud cake. It is unbelievable. 38 out of the last 39 Geelong games, he's had 15 touches. Did you hear that, Darce? 38 out of 39.
38 out of 39.
This bench, fuck. It should be in every single 100K bet, and I've come here to make a stand, but I think what's happened is the line, it's gone out a little bit because Geelong started so slowly. Yeah. This will come into $1.10 by what, round 10?
Probably.
But yeah, we'll gobble up $1.25. So just use this again and
what
we roll on.
What a leg,
Luke. Probably winning goal of the year as well, by the way.
Well done to fucking kick us off. Boys, no legs for me, but Italy in the water polo World Cup, boys. Clear favourites starting next month. $2.50. They absolutely love water polo, the Italians.
A Mick Malloy bit or
the Italians absolutely love it.
Mixed multi.
I hope you've got a leg.
I won't give you that.
Hawks versus Adelaide, boys. Is there anything from the Hawks or the Crows?
The Prince of Adelaide for two. The Young Wizard for two. Isaac Rankin for two snags at $1.59. How fucking good is this bloke? If you don't think he's kicking two against the Hawks down in Tassie, you are dead set wrong, Lewis. Yeah. He's kicked 12 goals in five games for the year. Absolutely love this shit leg. Absolutely love Isaac Rankin. Love everything about him. He is kicking two. Isaac Rankin, two goals. Lou.
Now, did I get in? I can't remember. Did this get in my leg? I think it did. Adelaide head-to-head, $1.27.
I think it got in.
I think it did. Let's pretend it did. But I think it's probably time now to crown him. Do we not crown them a contender? So you guys gave them 8%. Now, I'm not calling you out.
Oh, they're in.
They're in? Great. 8% you gave them on the premiership pie 2 weeks ago on Hook, Line and Sink. It's a great show. It comes out Wednesday, Thursday morning. 8%, I reckon 8% goes up. Last week, Darce, they made Carlton look horrendous. And we talked about this, Jeff, during the week, but it's the sort of list, when they're winning, they look unbelievable. Yep. It's the perfect mix of experience and youth. And I think they're definitely finishing top eight. I know that's early, but $1.27 just to beat a pretty average Hawthorn side. Again, it's 3 from 3 from me and carry on. And if you give
come
us,
on here, come yeah,
if you give us a mixed leg, I'll go off.
Just quickly, Darce. I'm just looking at Morgan's notes. Just taking the Crows here. They're hotter than Kath Lachlan at the moment.
How come you didn't say that?
I missed it. Well, I was thinking about it.
I said it. Told, oh, geez, Kath is a piece of work. No legs from me, boys.
I'm trying to get her to come on the show.
You know, she was only 29.
Well, it's not relevant.
I'm a chance. We're trying to get you to come the same age.
Cut this.
Come on, Kath.
She'll be
love
watching
you
as well.
No legs, boys, from me. All right, next game. You're on your Mick. The Blues.
You didn't have a leg in that game.
Nah.
Any of your Mick Malloy jokes?
No. Nah, I can't say it. All right, next game. The Blues and the Saints.
I got two legs in this game. Jack snags Higgins for two at $1.73. Jack Higgins for two goals at $1.73. He's kicked 11 in his last 3 weeks. Crawled to two last week, but got there. He absolutely loves it under the lid. He loves it at Marvel. I think this is just a lock. I love this. Like, he gets that many shots on goal every week. 4 and 5 the weeks before last week. Yeah, $1.73 is great value for the 100K. Come back to me, Lewis.
So I've got a bit of an essay for you here, but this is good analysis, Darce. This is good cogent analysis.
Good.
So Riley Filthorpe.
you said that really well.
Didn't I? Pays $1.22 for any time, right? Didn't have a shot on goal last week and only kicked one goal against Freo the week before.
$1.22.
Dylan Moore pays $1.21 for an any time goal. He only kicked one goal last week. Did not have a shot on goal the week before. Lastly, Jev, friend of the show, our boy Will Hayward. Anytime snag pays $1.43, has not kicked a goal in 2 weeks.
Fuck.
This bloke, $1.78 for any time. Corey Durden kicked two last week and he's kicked one goal each of the last 4 games. He's kicked 2 goals his last 2 appearances at Marvel and I'm getting $1.78. Tell me where I've gone wrong here. I don't get it. Filthorpe, Moore, Hayward,
and you're getting $1.78 for Durden anytime under the lid.
If you know why,
off Charlie. Yeah. Oh, what a leg, Lou.
If you know why,
done some work.
It's fucked.
Yeah, great leg.
That's fantastic. Boys, I'm going to take Charlie Curnow for 3 under the lid. I know this may seem like a lot, Jeff. I know Wilkie's in the pyramid, but who's higher on the pyramid?
Yeah, smart.
And that is Charlie. And until I don't see something wrong from him, I absolutely love him, boys. 3 goals, $1.99, just shy of $2. Really boosted up the multi. And also, big Quipsy for 25. The reigning Brownlow medalist, $1.40 for 25. Boys, averaging 28 so far this year. He had a shocker last week. Couldn't get near it. Loves it under the lid. A little bit more grunt work. Blues really need to start surging at the source. I reckon we're really in for it. And also, I've got Morgs for 10 beers by halftime.
I agree.
Yeah, one more leg. Jack Sinclair for 25 at $1.43. How does the best bet in football blow out to $1.43? Sinclair's start to the year has been as good as anyone in the comp. It's been unbelievable. He's had 26, 33, 26, 31, 27. So this bet is 100% on the year. Yeah, well, we're getting $1.43 under the lid against Carlton. This is an absolute lock. Love this in the 100K.
You'll make some Saints fans happy.
And you're going, Morgs? You'll be there?
Oh, I am, yes.
Well done. So make sure Morgs will be doing a little meet and greet out the front. So make sure you bring your...
More of a behind the camera role at the moment, I don't know.
All right, boys, next game, Gold Coast and North Melbourne. Jeb,
as you notice, I'm wearing a North Melbourne turtleneck.
The blue wiggle.
The blue wiggle. The LD, I'm LDU's biggest fan. LDU for 25 at $1.33. Look, he only had 23 last week. I don't think that was his fault. North put on the worst kicking display in the 150-year history of the AFL. They missed every second kick coming out of the back line and they were dead set horrible. I'm looking at the young king to bounce back and he'll get 30 if we're honest. He'll go back to 30, but we are taking him for 25 at $1.33. This is an absolute lock, Lewis.
Well done. Did the Wiggles have a song called Wake Up Mick Martin? give me North Melbourne Darts plus 42.5, $1.31. I just think this is a letdown spot for the Suns. North were just outclassed last week by a better Brisbane side, better, a bit tougher, more experienced. Yeah, but they're not going to be, I don't think they'll be like that this week. Clarko would have given them a grilling, and I just don't think they're going to be intimidated for the Suns. I don't know who goes with them. I've got 37.5 points. Is that right, Darts? $1.40. No, I've got, you gave me 42 points. 42 at $1.30. So, look, they're no certainty. $4.35 they pay head to head. I wouldn't mind a slice of that just for 10. Okay. But yeah, for 42 points, Darts, $1.31. It's a good leg.
Should cover.
I'll be taking Lockie Weller, boys, for 20-plus touches at $1.24. He obviously came back early from his ACL injury. It's usually 12 months. He was back in 9. Pretty much came straight onto the scene from round 1 this year. He's averaging 20 over 25.5. He's actually been taking a lot of their kickouts as well. He's one of their best ball users. They actually look to obviously go to him as much as they can because Matt Rowe still doesn't know how to kick a drop punt. So they try and get it to him throughout the middle. So we absolutely love Lockie Weller in this one, boys. 20 touches, $1.24. Moving on. Anzac Day Eve, boys. This is where it gets juicy. Melbourne and Richmond. Jev.
Nightclubs, golf clubs, strip clubs, and the 2 and 15 club. The four best clubs in the world. Give me Cozzy Pickett, 2 and 15.
Malcolm.
The value on this is absolutely fantastic for something that's hit 2 out of the 3 games this year. For 2, Cozzy's paying $1.60 when he's kicked 4, 2, and 2 in his 3 games this year. And for 15, he's paying $1.65 when he's averaging exactly 15 over his 3 games. He had 1 game with 19, 1 game with 11. And... want to know what gives me even more confidence in this leg?
Please.
The fact that Tom Papley tortured the Tigers with 6-25 last week and nearly retired.
Unbelievable.
3 champion Tigers. Cozzy Pickett, 2-15. Love the 2-15 club. This is an absolute lock. Anzac Day Eve, Lewis.
Yeah, I love that, Jeff. Going absolute live wire, Noah Cumberland, just for any time stags. Very Joel Jeffrey-like, this bloke.
Very.
Apparently, he's got a fucking hog on him as well. Apparently, at the club, they call him Cucumberland. So when I watched him last year, obviously, he was the one that held the ball in the draw, and I thought, if you ever think I'm betting on this bloke at 100K, you're dead wrong. But I absolutely love him. His forward presence is unbelievable. Do not slumber on Cumber. I just want him anytime, $1.25.
Come on.
That's a good leg.
Yeah, it's a great leg.
Boys, I found a little juicy honeypot here, but Alex Neil-Bullen for 15-plus touches. His last 2 Anzac Day Eves, he's had in 2021, he had 19-2, and last year, 27 disposals, boys, $1.82 for this little honeypot. You know how you know he's going to get there? He literally gets a touch for every kilometer he runs. So as long as he runs 15 Ks, he's going to get there. Do you have any more legs?
No.
All right. Do you have any more?
Negative.
Oh, so I got another 2. So I was I got Bailey Fritch, boys, for 2 goals. Think this is an absolute lock. $1.46. Literally a walking 2 snags. He's averaging 2.5 goals a game so far this year. And his last 2 Anzac Day Eves, he's kicked over 2+ against the Tigers. Then got to take Petrarca. Was either way was going to put him in. I think he's been playing really well. But obviously with Oliver potentially out, Gorn back in the side, they're just going to be getting silver service. That is $1.36 for 25+ touches. His last 2 Anzac Day Eves, boys, 25-1. And 38-1. Absolutely love his form. Unreal. Love these 3 legs. Love all the legs, actually, boys. And then we're getting into the final game, the Anzac Day match, Collingwood and Essendon. Jev.
I've got 3 legs. I'll just go 1, hand it off to you, Lewis. Sure. Darcy Parrish for 30 at $1.40. Why is a bloke who has had 37, 30, 35, 30, and 34 in his first 5 games of the year still paying $1.40 for 30? Give me all of that. Oh, absolutely love Parrish. Around the ball. He just gets it.
Yeah, well, Lewis. Done. Yeah, I've gone Sammy Draper just for any time. Now, tried to avoid the recency bias, obviously kicking three last week, but he swings forward Anzac Day, does he not? So, no McStay. Frampton will be busy elsewhere. We know that. He 100% swings forward. And it looked from last week that every time they swung forward, they had to go, I said like Dermy. Every time they... But every time the ruckman, and you saw Phillips kick one the last, I think, last 2 weeks, they have to target the ruckman to, you know, make the other blokes accountable. So, geez, I love this league.
Yeah, I love Drapes for a snag. Yeah, well done. Three last week, 23 to 1 for three, paid.
I wonder what my multi pays.
You got to put it on.
A lot. Now, boys, I'll be taking after the week off, DeGoey. This screams him. Like, this screams him. So, for a goal and 20 touches, they're both $1.30 each, boys. So, I think he's going to get near it. I reckon he's going to run absolutely wild. Conditions are meant to be perfect. About 25 and sunny, Anzac Day. I think it's going to be a cracking game of footy and everyone's going to get a lick of the ice cream. Do you have any more leads?
Yeah, I do. Nick Martin, anytime. Welcome to the 100K, Nick Martin. Yeah,
welcome. Welcome to 100K.
Just like a draft hat.
Who's got a better mustache?
Been drafted. You're one of the very few players in the comp averaging 20 touches and a goal. And I had a look at your form since round one. You've kicked one, one, two, two. So I'm more than happy to take you for a snag. And $1.50 we're getting. $1.50 for someone that kicks one every week, Lewis. You just love that form.
It's delicious.
You love that. He will kick a goal on Anzac Day. Very exciting to be in the 100K. Nick Martin.
What on Nick? Leg?
I don't.
One more leg. Nick Dacos for 30 touches. I said it on the Sunday roast. I said it on Hook, Line and Sinker. That I saw the leaked script of the Anzac Day game.
You did.
And they've already awarded Nick Dacos the Anzac Day medal. They've awarded him. He's an absolute lock for Anzac Day medal. This man is made to dominate this day. Absolutely loves playing on the MCG. Give me Nick Dacos for 30 at $1.34. When he gets this and we win 100K, I am going to be up and about, Lewis.
Do you have any more legs?
No, mate. I'm cooked.
That rounds us out. Now, boys, we've started skinny and we've gone really fat. If this still is riding on Tuesday, this will be fucking unbelievable.
Let's go.
Here we go.
If it's on. Like,
if it's alive.
If it's alive.
Just go to the corner or something. Yeah. We're going into the
just
G.
Just get near it.
Yeah, 100%. All right, boys. This is an absolute monster. A 25-legger. We need $10.10 on this. Probably one of our closest, actually, to the $10 mark. So $10.10, boys. No. We have Tui for 15. Cameron for 2 and 15. Let's that go. Gets us on to the next game. Then we've got Isaac Rankin for 2 and Adelaide head-for-head.
Oh, this is a good start.
Don't overthink it, lads, so far. We've got Charlie Cameron for 3. Quipsy for 25. Sinclair for 25. Higgins for 2. Corey Durden walks for 1. Gets that many shots on goal. We love this leg. Now, North Melbourne plus 42.5. Weller for 20 and Davies Uniac to bounce back, boys, with 25 touches. Neil Bull and Little Honeypot there, boys, for 15. Petrarca 25. Fritch for 2. Noah Cumberland or Cozzy Pickett for 2 and 15. That gets us through that game. Then our last one, DeGoey for a snag. Draper for a snag. DeGoey for 20. Dacos for 30. Parrish for 30. And Nick Martin for an anytime. That is an absolute cracker, boys. $10.10 for $100,035.04. Let's go.
It's a hell of a bet.
Let's go.
I love it. Boys, we're feeling confident about this. So, yeah, obviously no bet on the first couple of games and just ease into it. And then we'll really get onto the Sunday, Monday and Tuesday slate.
For the 100 people that are in the 10K Punters Club, we can't wait to reveal the multi to you very soon, straight after the show. That'll be on our Insta. If you're in the bet with mates, you can obviously already see it. Go have a look. Very exciting.
Here comes the money. About to be on.
Starting right now.
There goes the money with me.
There goes Darcy's money.
Sunday
did you ever win it last week?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, we're back.
Sunday night, Monday morning, Sunday roast.
Sunday roast.
Thursday morning, Hook, Line and Sinker. It's all happening.
Let's go.
Patreon, Discord.
Discord, Patreon. Make sure you guys get around because we actually would love to know like some numbers at the start. Then we can really start to chew into it. It's going to be good. Do you have an idea about when we'd launch that?
Hopefully next week.
Next week.
That's the game.
Fuck, that is so good.
Discord is going to be fun as. Just talking with all of yous. We all know who's kicking the first. We're going to all ride bets together. 100K gets posted. We're going to talk about NBA playoffs, whatever anyone wants to talk about.
This is genuinely going
to
be
It's going to be so exciting.
We're going
to
live on Discord.
Be chatting with everyone. Because we get so many individual DMs from everyone, but we can't all talk together. I can't wait to have everyone in the same group.
Upper.
Let's go. Well done, lads. Hey, round six. This is the fucking week. Now, if this hits, boys, we are going to actually quit our jobs legit and we're just going to do this full time. So let's make sure this one hits. Blues. Fuck. Oh, Blues by 5 points. Not confident.
Swans by a goal at the unveiling of the flag.
Chili. Baby back ribs.
Ribs.
Arriba.
Here comes the money right now.
There goes the money with Dobe.